इंटीग्रल ऑफ ई टू द पावर एक्स माइनस वन प्लस एक्स टू द पावर ई माइनस वन अपॉन ई टू द पावर एक्स प्लस एक्स टू द पावर ई डी एक्स. इन दिस इंटीग्रल यू कैन सी इट डज नॉट लुक दैट न्यूमरेटर इज डेरिवेटिव ऑफ डिनोमिनेटर, बट ऑन डिफरेंशिएटिंग दिस डिनोमिनेटर वी फाइंड ई टू द पावर एक्स प्लस डेरिवेटिव ऑफ एक्स टू द पावर ई इज ई इंटू एक्स टू द पावर ई माइनस वन बिकॉज ई इज अ कॉन्स्टेंट. सो इट सीम्स टू बी दैट न्यूमरेटर कैन बी मेड डेरिवेटिव ऑफ डिनोमिनेटर. सो ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ दिस ऑन दिस ग्राउंड वी कैन पुट डिनोमिनेटर एज टी. We are just predicting that numerator may be derivative of denominator. It is not certain that it will be, but we are trying to see it. So on putting t is equal to denominator, and as you know that whenever we put something in indefinite integral, we are supposed to differentiate at the same moment. So on differentiating this with respect to x, left side will be dt by dx, right side derivative of e to the power x is well known to you, and about derivative of x to the power e is e into x to the power e minus 1. How comes? Because derivative of d dx of x to the power k for any constant, it is k into x to the power k minus 1. If power is constant, then differentiation will be like this. D dx of x to the power k, and here you can see that e is a constant. Why e is a constant? Because its value is approx 2.7 something, and the number is known as Euler's number, and its value is fixed like pi, and it is an irrational number. And being an irrational number, we do not write its value because it is non-terminating, non-repeating. That is why we replace this as with a symbol known as e. Now dt by dx is equal to this much, which we can write if we try to match this with the numerator of the given integral. Let the integral be I, let the integral be equal to I. If we try to match this result with the numerator of the given integral, we can see that numerator e to the power x minus 1 plus x to the power e minus 1. So in numerator you can see x to the power e minus 1 has coefficient only 1, but here it is e. So we need to take e as common. So if we take e common, but in the first term you can see that we have only e to the power x, and we have taken common e, so the denominator will have now e plus here x to the power e minus 1, and dx we can transfer on right hand side. So the integral, the expression looks like this, which we can write dt upon e is equal to e to the power x, and denominator is e whose power is 1. If it is not written, it means power is 1. So using law of indices, it becomes e to the power x minus 1 plus x to the power e minus 1 dx. Now you can match numerator and this right hand side and numerator of the given integral, both are, and therefore the integral I can be replaced by what? Therefore the integral I can be replaced by dt by e is what? Numerator, because you can see e to the power x minus 1 plus x to the power e minus 1 dx is dt by e. So it is dt by e, and denominator you can see e to the power x plus x to the power e, we have substituted as t. So denominator will be t. Again, as usual, you can see that numerator is complete because it is having something in denominator, but denominator is incomplete because it is nothing, it is not having anything in denominator. So this denominator we can write as t by 1. Now you can experience that 1 will be multiplied with dt and e will be multiplied with e. As I told you that e is a constant, so it can be taken common. 1 by e common from the integral. Integral, okay, dt by t, wait. 1 by e integral of dt by d is log of t base e with modulus plus c. And at the last, we shall put value of t. Log of e to the power x plus x to the power e base e plus